So I'm traveling through Kansas, and I'm over here on 60 by Barber. I'm between Barber and Coldwater. I've got the drone with me. It's in the back there. I've also got these guys here. Maybe I'll do some flying. Look at that. You can barely see. I'm up in a high level where normally when you're driving this way, you can see for miles. Miles and miles and miles. You can't see jack. It's all the smoke. So I've got to go through Ashland, Kansas. This is how dark it is in front of me. And I just heard on the radio that you can't get within 7 miles of Ashland because Ashland has been evacuated due to the fires. Kind of a shitty deal. This is really dark. So there it is, guys. You can see where it went over the road here. It's all scorched. And I just went right through it. That was crazy. This is a whole town of people, guys, that luckily look like was spared. There's the line right there. Looks like they battled that. Oh, that's a house out that way. They must have battled this area hard last night. This is the town that I've got to come to that got evacuated last night. It's just right on the other, I just got through Ashland, right on the other side, there's just more. I mean, they are surrounded by this fire everywhere. Oh my God, that's hay bales. I thought that was a house for a second. They are just surrounded. It's crazy. Couldn't help it, had to get the phantom out. But if you'll notice in the video,
I made sure that I was in a place that was nowhere near the fire, and the big smoke plumes are far away. The place where I was at, everything's pretty much put out. There may be black areas, but it's pretty much put out. And I'm not going to be in the way of any fire departments or sheriff's departments or anything like that. The main thing about this hobby is making sure that safety comes first, and that also includes people on the ground safety, and also the safety of sheriff's departments and fire departments and things like that, and making sure that you're in full cooperation. Because the last time we had a grass fire out here, it was about 40 miles east from here. It was a pretty big one, and there were so many drones in the air that they actually put out a news thing stating if you're caught with a drone, then you were going to be in trouble. And it didn't do any of us drone owners any favors by having them people out and getting in the way of everybody. So
there's a fire truck, old fire truck. There's a water tanker. Looks like they're refilling. Right there. Yeah, they got a hose there for water. I've got my session right there. I love this little anal bead looking thing. I can kind of wrap it around anywhere and get it to set right. Man, it's just brutal.
Alright, so we're coming back into Ashland. I gotta go back through it. Some of the people out here are some of the hardest working women and men of all time, and it's sad to see farms and homesteads and businesses and all sorts of things just up in smoke, on fire, or burned to the ground. I suggest everybody pray for Western Kansas, Central West Kansas, because you can still see it still on fire. Not only that, but while I'm down here, there's other fires going on in Southern Dodge City. And in Hutch, I heard, is really bad. In fact, I came this way because I wanted to avoid going through this stuff. And I heard that Hutch was getting really bad, so I didn't want to go through that area. So, still came down here and it just broke my heart.